very hostile. And when you come to the next page, the first paragraph, again the word repeated, hostile time. And as a result of their condition, the narrator is explaining, usually a human life should be filled with the virtues, good qualities. But here there was no such a chance. So what they have to do is, either by stealing or whatever they can do, they have to live as far as or as best as they can. So stealing is actually not a virtue, but in order to live as a refugee, and these virtues were secondary, and that is what the narrator is explaining in that paragraph. And everything else was secondary. Now their main virtue is leave. And in the next paragraph onwards, and their efforts to fill the basket, you can see there. And there was a compromise made in between Isam and the narrator, that is, the best thing filled in the basket will be eaten by them when they were returning back home. And in the next paragraph, you can see their fortunes, their misfortunes. And now the situation was very worse because it was a very cold winter season. And normally the roads are very wet. And also their condition was also very horrible like that. And now that day, they wanted to fill their baskets with apples. And now they filled the baskets with apples. When they were returning home, they started eating the best apples from the basket. And in the next paragraph onwards, you can see, while they were returning home, our narrator found out a very interesting thing on the road of the street. And now there is a policeman is watching in the main street, and he had seen in between the boots of the policeman a piece of money was there. So he did not know exactly what was the amount, but anyway he understood it was money. Our narrator wanted to grab that money as soon as possible. But the problem is, the money he found in between the boots of the policeman. And as soon as the narrator had seen it, Issa might also have noticed it. But before anybody could grab the money, our narrator wanted to grab it. So in that hurry, the policeman was about to fall in that street. That made the policeman very angry. He started whistling, and when he started whistling, the whole people gathered in the street, and they were also very alert, and they tried to catch this boy. And now in that paragraph, there is again the word hostility. Hostile time is explaining, because our boy, narrator, he had to escape himself from this policeman and the other people, shopkeepers, etc. So he was in a hurry to save himself. And there also you can see the second comparison. That is, he is explaining his condition like a soldier. So when a soldier was attacked by the enemy soldiers, and he will be trying to escape from the battlefield as soon as possible. So like that, our narrator was trying to running through the street as fast as he can, so that he will not be find out by the policeman and the other people. And that efforts that you can see there. And in the next page, page 164, first paragraph, and you have seen that paragraph onwards, you can see what was the response of his family members. And by the time he came back home, the entire family members, they were eagerly waiting for our narrator. And he was imagining what lie Issa might have told about all these things to the family members. Anyway, each of their response you can see in the next second paragraph onwards. Especially the grandfather's response, their facial expressions, etc., you can see. And now when you are coming to the last paragraph of that page, the father came forward with a compromise, that is 50 of the amount. It was actually a 5 pound amount, and now the 50% will be for the father and the 50 will be given to our narrator. But our narrator was not ready for such a compromise. And in the next paragraph, you can see in page number 165, and the family members tried to threaten our narrator, but in return our narrator tried to threaten them. So how did the family members respond? That you have seen in the next paragraph. They tried to warn him, and then they tried to hit them. But when the situation became very serious, our grandfather intervened. He tried to save the narrator. That was also another quality about our grandfather, that you can enter in the character sketch of the grandfather. And now, at last, there was a compromise. That compromise is when the situation became very favorable, or when the winter season is over, the grandfather will take all the children for shopping or something, and then they will spend the money. That was the compromise made. And in the